Hello, welcome to the program, Your Opinion Radio Global. How are you doing today? I'm sure you're doing good because me, I'm doing very great. Alright, you know how we're doing on the program. It's always very interesting and very, always something to look up to, something to talk about. Okay, in case you missed the program last week, we talked about what's the kind of ideal man or woman. It was so interesting to have guests in the studio with me that we discussed about that. But today we'll be talking about something very different and something that you are going to be very interested to talk about. Okay, alright. Today we're going to talk about something different, like I said earlier, and I have guests in the studio with me. But you know how we do it, I do the introduction when I come back from a short break. Alright, the program is still Your Opinion and this is Radio Global. My name is Tumi Bamidele Olariwaju. Don't go anywhere because I'll be right back.
Follow me, go, you can't follow me. He say, sister, sister, please wait, I wanna talk to you all again. I say, tell me, what do you want? Make it all be like, say, I do the front. He said, it's only gonna take 1 second. He gonna ask me stupid question. Have I met you before? Is your brother boy? Did you go to my school? Cause I recognize you. Do you live next?
Alright, welcome back. The program is still Your Opinion and this is Radio Global. Alright, in case you're just joining in, we're just starting, so you've never really missed anything. Alright, like I said earlier, today we have my wonderful guest in the studio. We have Jeremiah here in the studio with me. Hey Jeremiah, how you doing today?
What's up, bro?
Alright, I have told you in the studio, the wonderful you. Told you, how you doing today?
Fine.
You look so dull, what's wrong? Hope you're fine. Alright, and I have the rainbow in the studio, so KG's here.
You just have to say the rainbow part, didn't you?
So how are you doing today, KG?
I'm good, Billy.
Alright, okay. Alright, okay, so just listening, the program is Your Opinion, and this is Radio Global. Okay, before I talk so much, let's go straight to what we want to talk about today. Alright, today's topic is, do you like yourself the way you are, or you prefer to be another gender? What's your opinion to this? Alright, when this came to my mind, the first thing I thought was, okay, do I like the way I look like, or do I still want to be another gender? Probably I want to be a lady, or I don't like being a guy. I don't know. But let me know what you think about that. Do you like the way you are, or you prefer to be another gender? Let's know what your opinion is on this. The number to call in is 01-2951-843. Let me take that again. 01-2951-843. You can also make your comment on our social media. You can go to Twitter, that's a Radio Global NG, and don't forget to use the hashtag Your Opinion before you put on your comment, so we can actually read your comment for us to know it for the particular program. Alright, don't forget to put the hashtag Your Opinion before you comment, so we can actually read your tweet. And you can also like our Facebook page. What you just need to do is go to Facebook, www.facebook.com/RadioGlobalNG. You can also make a comment there. Let's know what your opinion is on this topic. Do you like the way you are, or you prefer to be another gender? For me, I think I like the way I am. But for you, I don't know if you want to change your gender or you just like the way you are. If you are, let's know what you feel about this. Alright, and don't forget the number to call in. It's still 01-2951-843. Don't go anywhere because this is Radio Global and I'm sure you're going to enjoy this. Alright, so the wonderful told you, like we were saying backstage, you were telling me something that hell yeah, you were thinking. But I've actually loved to be a guy, you know.
Yeah.
But at a point, you lost interest of actually
was,
being
yeah,
a guy.
Yeah,
so, do you want to tell me about it?
Alright, because I think when I was rather young, because of the way I grew, because I think I was like a real tall boy when I was little.
Okay.
I sort of knew a whole lot of things that I had to do, guys. So I mean, when it came to dressing and stuff, I knew a whole lot of stuff because I sort of grew being very close to my brother. I guess you know so many things. So maybe that was the reason why I was you really got to have seen me when I was secondary school. Seriously. But I never lost that feeling inside of me, which was really that of a girl.
Okay.
Yes. But the thing about it now is that I've gotten to a level whereby I now appreciate who I am. I appreciate me, myself, as a lady. I appreciate being a female. Okay. Being as I am now, I will never ever want to be a man for no reason. Because I think God made me for a reason, and you knew I made me a lady. So I think I just had to realize it and say that, yes, sir. For God to make me a woman, that means there's something very, very special about me, and there's something else to do in my life. So why would I want to become a man? Being a man, seriously, there are a whole lot of challenges, just like being a woman. So you will not say for the man it's more or for the woman it's more. Everybody has their own equal and fair share of life's troubles. But the thing about it is that just appreciate who you are. Me, I would not want to be a man.
Alright, okay. Okay, thank you.
I would want to be a woman over and over again.
Okay, thank you so much for that. Alright, let me go back to Jmy. Jmy, what did you take to the example?
I don't think that's going to happen. Nah, I won't be a disgrace to my parents. You get what I'm saying? I won't be a disgrace to my parents. Because my family, I don't think there has in the history of my family has ever been anyone transgendering from a male to a female. But based on that issue about people converting to to the opposite sex, I think there are different factors one can look at. There are different factors one can look at. Some of them, they just for some it's insecurity. They are not secure about the kind of person they are. They feel the need to they feel the need to express themselves, because they've been tagged wrongly. Society has a lot to do with people, converting to the opposite sex. There has been pressure. A guy, for instance, who is good with expressing emotions.
Okay.
Who understands, because a man understands the woman. He knows everything about the woman.
Okay.
It doesn't necessarily mean he is a woman. You get what I'm saying? But society would tag him to be one. You'll be like, oh, that guy is gay. That guy is a woman. He does ladies stuff. Just because he does that, that makes it a woman now. It's different. I can start up a company that deals mainly with beauty products about women, because I know women love it, because I have passion for the beauty of the woman and all that. But just because I'm into it, people start tagging me to be like, oh, that guy is not a man. Why would he be doing cosmetics? Why would he be doing these sort of things and this and that? So you tend to find out that this person feels insecure about who he is. About, okay, this is who I am, but I don't have to change. But in order to just like, okay, let me express myself. Okay, since they say this is who I am, this is what I'm like, okay, let me just be this person, and I know I'm free.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I know I'm free, but that's the wrong way they go about it.
Oh, okay.
That's the wrong way they go about it. Just because people don't accept you, the way you are, for your personality or the way you do things, doesn't necessarily mean you should go and transgender, change your sex and all that. It's actually wrong. Even to God, I think it's wrong.
Okay. Yeah, alright, thank you so much for that. Alright, let's go to music break, and when we come back, we'll still hear more. Okay, Marine Kai, stay in the building. I have told you, I have Jmy, in case you just joining the program, is here your opinion, and this is Radio Global. Okay, today we're talking about, do you prefer the way you are, or you would prefer to be another gender? Do you like the way you are, or you prefer to be another gender? Let's know what you think about this. Let's know what your own opinion is on this. The number to call on is 012-951-843. I'll take that again. It's 012-951-843. Call us up. Let's know what your opinion is on this. And you can also do that with our social media. You can go on the Twitter, and Radio Global NG. And don't forget to use the hashtag your opinion before you comment. Put the hashtag your opinion before you comment so we can actually read your comment out. And you can also like us on our Facebook page. Just go to www.facebook.com/Radio Global. Just go there, like our page, and let's know what your opinion is on this topic. Don't go nowhere, enjoy the music break, and we'll be back.
I say now is the time to know the people who got the money. It's about the money, the thunder of the money, not the ordinary money. Kawa, 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 adu, 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 adu. Oh yo yo. Any man we get the big money, call him the robuchi. Any man we get the big money, call him the robuchi. Don't just say you get the big money, you be the robuchi. Ego tsunami, oh my God, you be the robuchi. Fuck up a man like the Riza, you be the robuchi. Good man, me you kundo you go try, you be the robuchi. Chairman, whatever the man they got on one, you be the robuchi. Dorobuchi, I'm Dorobuchi, biggest Dorobuchi. Dorobuchi, no regai last. Dorobuchi, over everything, everything. Dorobuchi, na di yoga, yoga. Dorobuchi, na di baba. Dorobuchi, no regai last. Dorobuchi, na di everywhere. Dorobuchi, over everything. Dorobuchi, na di yoga. Dorobuchi, Dorobuchi, Dorobuchi. Dorobuchi, 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 Dorobuchi.
Some Dorobuchis, the Dorobuchis with the revolution streets. When they enter the place, they be feeling their feet. They put up your hands, say Dorobuchi. Ayurina, Dorobuchi. Amajuna, Dorobuchi. Dangote, na Dorobuchi. Anotetola, na Dorobuchi. Oh my God, it's Dorobuchi. Na woman, I still be Dorobuchi. From the Alakota, na Dorobuchi. Kini, Dota, na Dorobuchi. Chimoya, na Dorobuchi. Dr. Sina, Dorobuchi. We call Abriana, Dorobuchi. We got the father, Dorobuchi. Dorobuchi, no regai la. Kari la, Dorobuchi, over everything. Everything, Dorobuchi, na di oga. Oga, Dorobuchi, na di baba, oh. Dorobuchi, no regai la. Kari la, Dorobuchi, na di everywhere. Dorobuchi, over everything. Dorobuchi, na di oga. Dorobuchi, 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 Dorobuchi.
It's Radio Global, redefining your radio experience.
Dorobuchi.
Alright, welcome back. That was the Dorobuchi I Love version. The Don itself, Don Jazzy and Dr. Seed on that one. I hope you enjoy it. Alright, okay, so just joining in the program, see your opinion on this. Is Radio Global. Alright, you know how we do it on this program. We bring up different topics on every segment, and you know how the topic always goes. Let's bring your mind and all the things you want to always talk about. Okay, today we're talking about, do you like the way you are? how you prefer to be under the agenda. Do you like the way you are? You prefer to be under the agenda. Okay, you can contribute on this program. You're calling to know what your own opinion is on this. The number to call in is 01-2951-843. That's the number to call in to be a part of this program. Okay, you can also go to social media. You can drop down your comment. Just go to Twitter. Twitter is at Radio Global NG. Twitter is at Radio Global NG. All right, and don't forget to use the hashtag Your Opinion before you comment. Remember to put your hashtag Your Opinion before you comment so we can actually read out all the comment. All right, and you can also like our Facebook page. Just go to Facebook. Type www.facebook.com/RadioGlobalNG. All right, before we went on the musical break, Jeremiah was actually telling us about what if you about the, you know, people that always want to actually change their gender from what they are or from who they are to another particular of gender. All right, okay, before we go on the musical break, KG was about to say something, but I had to put that on hold. Okay, now we're back. KG, you want to say something about... You were telling me you don't like the way you are, like you used to be a tomboy way back or something.
Can you just take a cue right now?
Okay, tell me about yours. What's your take to this?
No, let's go ask what you said about me.
Yeah, okay, you know, we'll talk about that later.
So, I
what's
your
what's your opinion on this?
The thing about transgendering is that people that are doing it, I don't know whether most of them are, according to what they've told us. I can't really put on the net. They have a reason for doing it. They are saying that they've been feeling like they're not feeling themselves either as a man, or they're not feeling themselves as a woman. We've seen men transgendering into women. I've seen women transgendering into men. So let's take Bruce Jenner for example. According to him, he said he has always been feeling he has never felt good in his skin before. He has always felt like a woman inside. And he has always known that, but he never voiced anything out.
Okay.
Though he said he told some people back then, which his first wife confirmed that. But when she and Bruce were together, he told her that he actually would like to be a woman.
Okay.
But then transgendering was something that was not common, and if we had done it, would have been kind of awkward, and how would I put it? It's like a kind of one in a million thing back then,
okay.
Which is not anymore right now. So, actually, like I heard Jerry say something about insecurity,
yeah,
or feeling insecure. I would say actually that's actually one of the main things about transgender. When you are insecure, that you feel like this person that you are, you're not a man enough, or you're not a woman enough. So you feel like when you transgender to the opposite sex, you actually tend to be bold, and you tend to be maybe before when in your own skin you feel like an introvert, you don't communicate with other people, you're not able to express yourself, you know, maybe in opinions that maybe you're meant to support, in opinion that because you're a man, you are expected to support men, but you feel like supporting women. Do it's your opinion, but you don't want to voice out because you're like, okay, you're a guy, they will look down on me and they'll be like, guy, what's wrong with you? How can you be supporting women? You're meant to support us, you're a man like us. So those kind of situations, they don't voice out, they don't speak out, they just keep quiet, and through that they become something else. You know, when you don't feel good and you just keep everything up here and you don't let it out, it leads to sickness of the body. So when you now have the chance to finally be who you've always wanted to be, you finally have the chance to like be a woman and express yourself and do everything that you wish that you had done, you know, things that you wish that you would be able to do, but you're not able to do, and just one day just have the chance and be like, okay, I'm going to go for it, I'm going to do this thing, I want to be a woman, I'm going to express myself, and anything I'm going to happen is going to happen. I don't care about what anyone says. And it's basically what Bruce has done, and everyone that has got everyone talking right now. Before I never knew who Bruce Jenner was until he became part of the Kardashian family. It was just, I just knew him as Kris Jenner's latest husband. But now that he said that he wants to become a woman, that he wants to express himself, like he has always wanted to, now I know him very well. I know him like, I won't say him like back, but what I've seen on the internet and what I've read about him, I know him that he's someone that he wants to be him. So even though it's late for him. I won't say it's really, really late for him, but he's old. Assuming he had the confidence back then, maybe when he was, let's say, maybe 30 plus or maybe even 40 plus, I would have said, okay, fine, kudos to him, he should go for this thing. But he's old right now, but he still thinks that he can still fulfill all those things that he has been wishing he could do if he was a woman. And now, which he has the chance to be right now. So.
Okay. Thank you so much for that. Okay, that was KG that was telling us about herself. Like, I was asking, how would it feel? Does she really like herself the way she is, or she would like to be a guy? She's trying to tell us that she doesn't feel comfortable with that. Okay, alright, the program is still your opinion. In case you're just joining in, this is Radio Global. Alright, you can be a part of this program. All you just need to do is call in and just know what your opinion is on this topic. Alright, the topic again is, do you like the way you are, or you prefer to be another gender? Let's know what your opinion is on this. You can also do that on my social media, just go to Facebook, or you go to Twitter. You can tweet at us at Radio Global NG, tweet at us at Radio Global NG, and don't forget to use the hashtag your opinion before you put your comment up. Alright, you can also like our Facebook page, just go to www.facebook.com/Radio Global. Alright, I'll be going on a musical break again, and when we come back, we'll be talking more about what your opinion is on if you like the way you are, or you want to be, or prefer to be another gender. Alright, don't go nowhere, just enjoy this music. Yeah, what's your name and where you calling from? This is Radio Global. Alright, Kemi, what's your take on this topic? Do you like the way you are, or you prefer to be under the gender? Oh, you never ever thought about being a guy, probably to knock some guy down or something? Okay, so you, because the responsibility of a man are so much, and you don't think you have the power or the energy to actually go through the struggle, so you feel you could be a lady, right?
Yeah.
Okay, alright, thank you so much for that. Alright, bye bye. Alright, you're welcome back to the program. It's to your opinion, and that was Break Free from Ariana Grande. I hope you enjoy that. Alright, we're talking about, do you like the way you hurt, or you prefer to be under the agenda? Alright, I have told you in the studio with me. I have Jeremiah here in the studio, and I have KG, the only OG boy in the studio with me. Alright, and they'll be telling us about what they feel about the topic. Alright, in case you want to be a part of this program, all you need to do is call us up and let's know what your opinion is on this. The number to call is 201-295-1843. Let's know what your opinion is. If you actually like the way you are, or you want to be another particular gender, probably a guy, you always want to be a woman, or you're a lady and you always want to be a guy, just call us up. Let's know what you feel like being, or you actually prefer the way you are. All right, and you can also do that on our social media. You can contribute on our social media. Just go to our Twitter handle. Just tweet that as a Radio Global NG. And don't forget to use the hashtag Your Opinion before you put your comment down. All right, and you can also like our Facebook page. You know, just go to www.facebook.com/RadioGlobalNG. Like our page there, and you can also drop your comment too on whatever you think is your opinion on this. All right, before we run and break, KJ was actually talking more about transgender and how people feel about it and all that. But my question now to KG is this: KG, you once told me, yeah, you know, back on her, you once said there was one time at a point that you used to be a tomboy. You play basketball, yeah. You said you play basketball a lot and all that. And have you ever had this feeling? Like, have you ever thought about it one day? Probably while you were playing with guys, and a particular guy, you know, overpowered you. Why, you know, if you're to be a guy, that would happen. Have you ever had this thinking? Have you ever come to your mind then that probably you would have loved to be a guy?
Okay. Throughout my life, I've been playing basketball. I've played with guys, but the kind of guys I've played with are the kind of guys that I actually beat.
Whoa. Jeremiah, I guess you need to be careful.
If I tell you, when I'm playing basketball, the ones I even fear when I'm playing basketball are the females that I'm playing with. Because I assume that they are big and tall. I'll be like, geez, who is this again? So I don't think there's ever any time that I've played basketball with guys and I'll be like, okay, this guy can beat me. Or I feel like I wish I was a guy so that I'll be able to overpower him. No, I've never actually felt that before. Being a girl, I actually have so much privileges. Trust me.
Okay, like, do you want to share? You want to talk about it? Okay, I'm listening.
Okay, let's take example. For example, in my house.
Okay.
I don't know if it happens in any other place. But my father tends to think that because I'm a girl, I shouldn't be going out too much. As in, like, he hardly sends me on errand. Apart from the ones maybe inside, okay, do this, but maybe to like go downstairs or go to the next street or go to this, he would never say me. Like, I'm a girl, I'm not meant to be doing those kind of things are meant for boys.
Ooh,
yes.
Okay.
The only thing he'd be like, okay, go to the kitchen. That's what you're meant to be doing. Even though I don't like the kitchen that much, but I still prefer it rather than him sending me somewhere or go and prepare something for him. Or I still prefer it a lot because I know the kind of things my brother do for him. I'll be like, seriously, you guys are trying.
So more or less like you're giving a kudos to a guy. So you never felt being a guy because you see just like the caller called earlier was saying, she actually never thought about it because looking at the responsibility guys actually go through and yes. they make doesn't even
top of major responsibilities they fall on guys' shoulders, trust me. And I know that yes, guys work with it because I have brothers and I know what they do.
So that actually have never make you feel or think about being a guy?
No. Okay. I've played with guys, football, basketball, I've done it, but I've never actually thought of... Even when I'm playing basketball or football with it, they actually tend to like take back, you know, the kind of strength I'm meant to use to play to a normal player. You know, guys with guys, at least. But when they see that it's a female, they at least step back a bit. You know, if you understand what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
They don't like put their power into...
There's always this self...
Yeah,
caution when it comes to ladies. Okay.
So when it comes to ladies, so I really enjoy that because it makes me want to like beat them, even though they will never show their true strength when it comes to playing this particular game with me. So it makes me be at least it seems as if we are kind of on the same level on that particular sport we are playing.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much for that, Jeremiah. Before we go on the musical break, you want to say something about what KG just said?
Well, I actually
All right, okay, let's go on this music break. And when we come out, we'll be talking more about do you like the way you are or you prefer to be another gender. All right, this is your opinion and the program is still your opinion. And this is Radio Global. Let me know where this is and enjoy the music break. And we'll be back right now.
H-Money. It's late in the evening, lost on the side. I've been sad with you for most of the night, ignoring everybody here. We wish they would disappear so maybe we could get down. I don't wanna know if you're getting ahead of the program. I want you to be mine, lady, to hold your body close. Take another step into the no man's land. I'm falling on his time, lady.
And did you, darling, come on, set the tone. If you feel the falling, won't you let me know? Oh, oh, oh. If you love me, come on, get involved. Feel it rushing through you from your head to toe. Oh, oh, oh.
Love is a blaze, I saw flames from the side of the station. The fire brigade comes in a couple of days. Until then, we got nothing to say and nothing to know, but something to drink and maybe something to smoke. Let it go until our roads are changed. Singing we found love in a local rave. No, I don't really know what I'm supposed to say, but I can just figure it out and hope and pray. I told her my name, I said it's nice to meet you. Then she handed me a bottle of water with tequila. I already know she's a keeper. Just from this one small act of kindness, I'm in deep. If anybody finds out, I'm meant to drive home, but I think all of it now. Not sobering up, we just sit on the couch. One thing led to another, now just kiss on my mouth.
I need you, darling, come on, set the tone. If you feel the falling, won't you let me know? Ooh.
H-Money.
No.
Soul music.
The other Friday, I never knew I'd meet her on my way. Returning from a party birthday. Baby, hey, I hold her down, say my mind. Say now maybe the one where they text you. Politely they address you. Remember me, baby, some call me. That's all I did. Baby girl, me boni can't take my head. Just wanna be with you anywhere you day. Any day, every day. Girl, when I think I might feel I'm not you. When I think I might feel I'm not you.
Every day, yeah.
She don't recognize she don't cheat either. Give me that special fever. She don't recognize she don't come on. Baby, the special one. She no regular, she no cheap either. She dey give me that special fever. She no regular, she no commander. Ooh, you're the special one. And I said to her, girl, I need you. Every day, every day. When I see you, you're messing up my mind. Make me wanna press rewind, girl. Till the first time I saw you, oh, I knew you were the one. And anything that I must do, say. Baby, I'll get it done.
That's all I get. Baby girl, you put me catching my day.
Just wanna be with you anywhere you be. Any day, every day. When I think of people, my feel I'm not you. When I think of people, my feel I'm not you.
Every day.
She don't recognize, she don't cheat either. Give me that special fever. She don't recognize, she don't come on. Baby, that's for sure. She no regular, she no cheap either. She dey give me that special fever. She no regular, she no come round. Ooh, you're the special one.
So many things I wanna do. Without you I don't fit through. Girl, my
special fever. She no regular, she no common. Baby, the special one. She no regular, she no cheap either. She dey give me that special fever. She no regular, she no common. Ooh, you the special one.
Welcome back to the program, Mr. Yo Pino and David Roba. I hope you enjoyed the song. Okay, I first played you a song by Ed Sheeran. I hope you enjoyed that. And I played you Special Fever by Daria Adelabe. I hope you enjoyed that also. Okay, the program is still Yo Pino and this is Radio Global. Okay, today we're talking about, do you like the way you are or you prefer another gender? I'm not the only one in the studio because you're just joining in. Have three people here in the studio with me. The wonderful Told You with the wonderful you, and have Jeremiah, Mr. J Maya, the Jerry Coy. Alright, and have KJ here in the studio, the only you can go in the studio with me. Okay, alright, if you want to be a part of this program, the number to call is 012-951-843. You can also make your contribution on our social media. You can just go to Twitter, that's a Radio Global NG, Radio Global NG, Twitter, that's a Radio Global NG, and don't forget to use the hashtag Your Opinion before you put your comment down so we can actually read them for you. Alright, you can also like our Facebook page. Just go to www.facebook.com/RadioGlobalNG. Okay, told you, Ryan KG was saying part of the reason why she never thought about, you know, being a guy too was actually the responsibility guys go through. But you say way back then when you were growing up, because you see the way your brothers do and you really like the way they do, and you always want to be, you're always inspired about them, and at a point you felt like being a guy. So looking at those responsibilities, would those things never give you a turn off to be a guy or something?
You're talking about responsibilities now, seriously, because when, well, for me now, I've gotten to learn that men, for men really, they have a whole lot of responsibilities. Like, they have their families to take care of. If the man is, if he's the first child of his family, he needs to take care of himself and make sure that his younger ones are towing the right line. And so many things like that, but maybe I believe that at that time I didn't really look at it in that way. I was like, this and that. No, boys are this and that. Boys are very strong and everything. They tend to do serious stuff. But when I was a little kid, I think I really loved the things that had to do with hard work, carrying heavy stuff and everything. So it was just a part of me. But getting to learn that, seriously, it's not just about that though. Being a man is not just about that. It's about a whole lot of things. So seriously, men themselves have their own aspect of it or part of it. Seriously, like for me, I can't be a man for no reason. No, no, not at all. I think I just like being a lady. I like being I like myself as a lady. Seriously, I like being a lady. You know, there are a whole lot of good things that come with being a lady. So I think I appreciate. I just appreciate myself more.
Okay, all right. Jeremiah was telling us about how so much he can actually cook, that he loves being in the kitchen and all that. All right, Jeremiah, with this, have you never felt like you're trying to act like a lady, or has nobody ever kind of look up to you like, why do you always like to cook, or why do you know how to cook so much, and why do you always like to be in the kitchen? Have you never had these challenges to, you know, make you think, am I trying to act like a lady, or am I trying to be a lady? Have you never, have this never actually occurred to you, or what?
Okay, well, it's at some point, it's a thing, you know, when, like you said, right, I said, I started cooking at an early stage when I was then I was like, okay, cooking is for, you know, women, you know, cooking is for, I was like, cooking is for women and all that, not a guy, not a man thing. And, but I got to fire, the situation there at hand was demanded that there was no other option because, you know, my mom wasn't always around and I couldn't starve myself, you know, to death. So I had to, like, you know, go to the kitchen, fix something up for myself. Then my mom would put me through on how to make things for myself also if she's not around and all that. So I also, you know, I actually enjoyed it. And what made me enjoy cooking then more was, like, I actually got to discover that, okay, women love men that can cook. So I was actually, like, I was actually interested in, you know, okay, I think women love that.
Okay, okay. I'm telling you, wait, hold on. I know you want to actually say something, but let your wife finish.
Women love a man that can cook. So I was like, okay, cool. I know how to cook, so okay, let me know how to cook some more. Yeah, you know, just there, you know, cook and all that. But you got to a stage, man, I actually find it hard, you know, to go to the kitchen and to cook. And my mom would be like, you don't cook for yourself, you start. I was like, no problem, I'll get myself something too. I'm going to choose that place and all that. But the basic thing is that, you know, I think one thing is there's always been something, you know, about a man, you know. There'll always be a feminine side to a man. Men have a feminine side. It could be anything.
Okay.
In any way, they have this feminine side, but their ego won't let them show it because, you know, they don't want people to, like, you know, say this guy is all gay, this guy is, you know, he's gay, this guy is all that and all that. But that doesn't actually mean they are gays and all that. They just, you know, have a feminine side. And women too, also, they have this, you know, this masculine side, you know. They have, you know, this portion of, you know, masculine side, like Keiji now, she has a part of a masculine side, in attitude and character.
Okay.
It's truth. But it's the truth. She just has it. The masculine side, but it does tends to be that, you know, people don't like, you know, showing that aspect because they don't want to, like, be tagged wrongly, you know, and all that. But it's only people who are confident, you know, people who are confident. Okay, I'm straight. I'm not gay or anything. I'm straight. This is who I am. Yes, I have a feminine side, or yes, I have a masculine side, but this is who I am. And that doesn't mean, okay, I'm this kind of person, I'm this kind of person. So I think, like I said earlier, you know, society, you know, plays a big role when it comes to people, you know, transgendering to the opposite sex. That's what I was saying. You know, one's personality, you know, doesn't really mean, you know, classifying you to be, you know, someone else, or rather classifying you to be the opposite sex or something. It's just, you know, the way for the person himself or herself to actually accept themselves. You know, okay, this is the kind of person I am. You know, this is who I am, but I'm not transgender because, you know, you think I talk this way because you think I act.
Okay.
Because you think I act this way and all that. That doesn't actually mean I'm a female and all that. Because it's when people start feeling that way. Because they need to, like, you know, express themselves. They need to, like, let something out without people judging them, without people, you know, judging them wrongly and all that. Okay, that guy, they actually be going to committing what they have been tagging them to, or what they've been tagging them to be.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
Tagging someone is a woman, is always tagging her, but because of that, you know, he feels as if he has to, like, express himself.
Okay.
You know, and all that. He's not as hard stone as you. Maybe he's a soft person and he feels he needs to, like, express himself, but you call him a woman and all that. And all that. Okay, actually, okay, let me go and be a woman. So okay. I can at least express myself and be free. and all that.
Okay, all right. Thank you so much for that. All right, KJ, before I caught you off the other time, you were about to say something when Jemai was talking about ladies actually like guys that can cook, and you wanted to put us a point there. Okay, will you say that quickly before we run out of problem?
Seriously, I think I'll agree to some extent with Jeremiah there, because I don't think there's any lady who would not want a man that can cook. At least not cook terribly, but at least a man who can cook the little things, so that if any lady just comes in and just like, let me cook, let me prepare, then I've had lunch, or don't worry, I'm making myself. Ladies like things like that, not having their man being pushed off by another lady.
Okay.
But not for the man to now use that as an opportunity to now say, because I can cook, I'll use this to lure this lady.
Okay. I guess we're gonna actually have a time for that, and we'll talk more about that, you know. All right, okay, before we go, in case you're just joining in, we're about to round up the program. It's still your opinion on the Radio Global, and what we've been talking about is, do you like the way you are, or you prefer to be another gender? That's what we've been talking about. All right, in case you're just joining in, we're about to round up. Okay, before we go, all right, KG, do you have anything you want to say before we round up the program?
I want to say is that, Jerry, why did you bring up my masculine side in the first place? What happened to it? Is it that you think that because I have this masculine side, I probably have this notion in my head that, oh, I think if I'm a man, I'm better than what I am right now. Is that what you think? Are you in my head?
I
say to people out there is that, okay, let me take myself for example. Okay, yes, I have this masculine side. I want to like, but one thing about it is that I have it because I was bred among boys.
Okay.
That's how he told me. I did not do all these 10-10 when I was young. I used to play football with my brothers. I'll ride bicycles with them. I'll run on the streets with them. I did all sort of things that boys used to do when they were young.
Okay.
So this masculine side of me is now saying, yes, maybe then I really wanted to be a boy or something. No.
It was just part of the growth up that actually made you to have the actually the masculine.
I was one of my brothers.
Okay.
So what about it is just that if you don't feel good in your skin right now, if you think that okay, transgendering is the way, then go for it. There are transgendering communities right now that support people that want to transgender, because most people that don't feel good in their skin, they are not able to transform to the other. To the opposite sex because of the backlash that is going to follow them from their community. But right now, there are communities that support transgendering, and there are people that are going to stand behind you and say that no, what you are doing is right. So one thing about this is just that do what you think it is right for you. Don't let anyone make decisions for you. If you think it is right, then it is right. If you know it is wrong, then it is wrong.
Okay, thank you so much for that. All right, thank you, Jeremiah, for being in the studio. Thank you, Toji, for having you here. And KG, thank you once again for always being here. All right, okay, this is where we're going to end the program today. Okay, we were talking about, do you like the way you are, or you prefer to be on the agenda? We've had different kind of attribute about it, and we've had different kind of reasons why people might actually not feel comfortable about the gender they are, and the reason why some people don't really have the privilege to express themselves, because they might not understand what the community or the people around might want to say about it. But above all, just be yourself, be whatever you want to be, but just make the best out of yourself. That's what really matters. And don't try to look at what people do to try and probably you want to do that also. Just be yourself and be natural. Alright, this is where we're going to round it up today. And don't forget, it's Radio Global, and the program is to your opinion. We'll be coming again next week, same station and same place, same time. Alright, okay, my name is Tumim Bamdi Alayiwaja. And don't forget, before I go, I'll leave you with this, give it to you. It's by Robin Tinkle, feature Kendrick Lamar. Alright, I hope you're gonna enjoy this. I'm giving this to you because the title is Give It To You. Alright, stay tuned. Bye bye for now. And don't forget, in everything you do, always put God first. Alright, I'm signing out. Bye.
For you. for you.
Let me give it to you,
baby.
I got a car for you.
I got a whip for you.
Black car for you.
Ball hard for you.
I know you wanna get fancy. I know you wanna start dancing.
Hey, girl, you know you're looking so damn fly. You're looking like you fell from the sky. You know you make a grown man cry. I wanna give it to you tonight. And make everything you fantasize come true. Ooh, baby, I make you so, so, so amazing.
I give it to you.
Girl, give it to me. Girl, give it to me. Girl, give it to me. Girl, give it to me.
Ooh.
What's that, girl?
What's that, baby?
I like that, girl.
I like that, baby.
Only that girl.
Only that girl.
Yeah, she got like that, girl.
Baby, baby,
I got an eye for you.
Got an eye for you.
Got a smile for you.
Cheers.
Let me put it on your face for you.
Please.
I got a taste for you.
Taste it.
I bought a lace for you.
Freaky.
I put it on you.
Yeah.
So I can go and take it off you.
Yeah.
And get it off to you.
Hey, girl, you know you're looking so damn fly.